So, Chris, how'd you get this car?
Like, I went to Charlestown, went to the finest Honda dealership there, and I said, let me lease your best CR-V. So I did.
What? Why would you lease a car? You don't own your own company. There's no point. Well, you're not going to own this after the deal's up.
Well, you know what? You know what? We'll talk about that later. But for now, let's focus on your graduation.
Welcome, Mr. Toomey.
Why, thank you, fine sir.
Congratulations, Mr. Toomey.
Thank you.
Hey.
So Billy, how's it feel to graduate?
Feels pretty freaking good. But can't stand these student loans I'm gonna have to be paying off.
Mm-hmm. So what are we gonna do about it?
You know, dude. Let's go hit the ATM right now.
I like it. Getting them out of the way early.
Yeah. I said to him, you can't get a cow half pregnant.
That's true.
Go. Back off.
It's just me, dude.
Alright. I don't know. Can I? I guess I can trust you. You gotta pay off the student loans.
Yeah.
Let's go. Where
are you going?
Oh. How you doing? Cigarette?
Yeah, I guess so.
Nice. You got a light?
Yeah. So you move in here recently?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, it's good price. Cheap.
Cheap? Yeah. My house is cheap.
Yeah. Where are you living?
Right down here.
Oh, holy cow. Yeah, that's cheap, all right. I've been stressing a lot recently.
What happened?
Well, I graduated from college, from Cornell, with an English degree. Everything was swell.
Yeah.
Then, started to have to pay back student loans.
Oh, kill ya.
Yeah, and to make matters worse, my best friend stole all my money.
You're kidding me.
Yeah, he went MIA after, so I haven't been able to do anything.
So you're broke.
I'm broke as a joke. I'm making $9.50 an hour at the Snack Shack over on 53rd.
You kidding me? I can help you out. Come with me.
So, what do you do, Mr. Johnson?
I'm a visionary.
Well, I don't know exactly what that is.
You'll learn about that more later. Just come with me.
Don't mind me. This is my friend,
Mr. Clifford.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Clifford.
He doesn't speak so much, but you gotta be careful when you're around him.
So what did you say your name was again?
Toomey.
Bill Toomey.
Bill Toomey, Mr.
Toomey. You say if you stick around with me for a little longer,
This is the life that you're gonna be living.
Holy mackerel.
$6.3 million house.
What?
I got that with a little hard work and some elbow deep. You know what I mean?
Is this your only one?
Nah, I got like three of them all around the country.
That out of yours?
Of course it is. One day it'll be yours. Wow. So, Mr. Toomey, why don't you tell me a little about this person that took all this money from me?
He's an old friend of mine. Knew him since way back in high school.
Oh, really? What was his name?
Michael Fabiano.
Michael Fabiano?
Yeah, Michael Fabiano.
I think he just said Michael Fabiano. Did you just stutter to me?
I did not stutter, sir.
Michael Fabiano?
Yes.
The grandson of Andrew Fabiano?
Yeah. This is a lot more serious than I thought it would be.
You're coming with me.
I think he went out west, somewhere hiding.
Went out west?
I know his father. Me and him, we have a little conflict going on.
Really?
Yeah, it's no big deal. I never met his father before. He used to talk about him.
Scumbag. I hate that man. So, Mr. Toomey, why don't you take a seat on this bench over here?
It's marble.
Beautiful.
So let me, let you in on some inside information.
All this money, it's not all for my business. It's more from gambling, counting cards, you know, just anything illegal I like to do. And the Fabianos are always getting under my skin. When push comes to shove, that's why I have my man Clifford right here. He doesn't talk much, like I said. But I think if you follow in my footsteps, not only will you get your money back, you'll quadruple it and have something like this with a beautiful wife.
Sounds really appealing, Mr. Johnson, but...
Hey, let me show you around a little bit, show you what my life is like. We'll see how it is after that. Well, come on.
Hey, this is the good life.
To the good life.
Homie, tell me what's good. Why I only got a problem when you in the hood?
Welcome to the good life.
Like I'm new in the hood. The only thing I wish
it was the
hood. Welcome to the good life.
He probably think he could, but I don't think he should.
Welcome to the good life.
50 told me, go ahead, switch the style up. And if they hate, then let them hate and watch the money pile up. The good life.
I come for mine.
Yeah.
I got to shine.
Now throw your hands up in the sky.
I go for mine. I got to shine.
So, what do you think about this, Phil? You in? Are you,
I have to say I'm definitely in, sir.
Just one pump. Keep it like that.
What? What are you doing? I told you to guard it Tuesday. Are you clipping? Get him out of my sight.
So, just meet me down by the res down there around 3 o'clock.
Yeah.
Brief meeting with you.
Sounds good, Mr. Johnson.
Good doing business with you.
Me too.
Nice of you to show up, Mr. Toomey. Right on time.
Likewise.
So I like to see him, man. How's it going?
Good.
See, you perfected that handshake you got going. The number one rule is to pay yourself first. You always gotta take 20% of your check and put it towards an account that you don't touch. You need that for emergency expenses. You know, you need it for like hospital bills or take it out of the time.
Yeah.
Number two is if you got credit cards, like I don't really like the light because it's easier to get tracked by the feds. But personally, if you need one, you always gotta pay off your debts every single month. Because if you let those build up your credit score, you'll never get a loan, even though you won't need it. Third thing you should do is cut back on discretionary spending. Like, you don't need to go out to the movies every night on the come up. You don't need to go out to eat the money. You always gotta be looking ahead too for your future. You gotta put some money away for retirement. Biggest mistake people make is thinking they have enough time. You're gonna need at least $1 million for your spending when you're older. I mean, you're gonna be retired at what, 65? You got plenty of years to live. So always put money away for retirement.
Why are we here, Mr. Johnson?
Remember that landscaper?
Yeah.
That screwed me over earlier? Didn't water my grass,
I guess.
Yeah, well, he's right here. We're gonna show you how we do it down in the O'Toole family.
Hold on, Clifford. You trust your loyalty. You ever kill a man? Huh? Search this man, Clifford.
Good job.
Congratulations on your first hit.
Thank you.
Got any money? What? What is it? You kidding me?
I thought you said that guy's name was Juan.
I thought it was Juan too.
What is...
Is this another Fabiano? On my land? Trying to be with me? Clifford, go get the men. Alright, well, now after that news, we gotta go deal with customers in 30 minutes.
What kind of customers?
I'm involved in kind of this Ponzi scheme. You ever heard of it?
That guy Bernie Madoff got in trouble
for.
Yeah,
exactly, but
I know Bernie Madoff.
So these people are gonna come down, give me a little money, run me some. I told them I'll pay him back. And we'll see about that one. Let's go meet them. We'll be down here in about 30 minutes. Here. Gentlemen, how's it going? So, why don't you guys take a seat?
Mr. Toomey, nice to meet you.
This is my new associate, Mr. Toomey. And that's my right-hand man, Cliff. Anyone of you would like a beverage?
No idea.
Shirley Temple.
Shirley Temple?
On the rocks.
Of course. Here you go, Mr. Shirley Temple.
So what do you say we get down to brass tacks?
Yeah. I like what you think.
So Mr. Johnson, why'd you bring me down here? How am I gonna get rich?
Well, Mr. Elphick, all I'm asking for is 20 G's. You front me 20 G's within 3 months, I'll give you back the 20 G's. And another 10 on top of it.
How can I refuse that?
So what's it, does it sound like a plan?
Sounds like a plan.
All right. Clifford, why don't you count this? Clifford doesn't talk too much, and he's not that good with math.
I mean,
it's a bit slow.
It makes me rich, I mean,
whatever works. Is it good? Alright. It's good doing business with you.
Yeah, it sounds like a
light. Mr. Johnson.
It's a pleasure. Okay. See you boys later. Clifford, why don't you escort him to the door?
You cannot be blamed if you never want to delve into the stock market again after the year that we've had
in
2000.
Kind of laugh about, but you can win.
But you know what? We can at least, we're in it together. There's nobody who made out in 2008 well. But with history as our guide, markets do crash and markets come back. They work in cycles.
That's interesting.
Hey, boss. You know what else is interesting?
Yeah.
You know cats can hear ultrasounds.
What the? Hello? Who is this?
Yo, it's Brick Fabiano. I heard you killed Carmine.
Yeah, Brick, what are you gonna do about it? Huh?
Honey, who are you talking to at this hour?
Give me a minute.
Okay.
You know what? Rez, 5 minutes. Bring your men.
Yeah, you think you can mess with me? The manure's about to hit the oscillator, Clifford. Get the muscle. Clifford, get the big cat.
Let's go, get to the rest! go, 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 go!
What are we doing?
Go! Okay. Go, go, go!
Slow down, slow down, slow down.
Not only do we got the numbers, boys, we got the size right here.
Cigarette, cardiac arrest, milkshake,
giant snake.
All right, whatever, keep going, keep going.
Johnson, you say we settled this, huh?
Serious?
Dead serious.
Hitting me? Woods, now!
Bring it on!
Possessions are gonna get divided up by the state.
I have no possessions.
Besties.
Put your weapons out!
We got high rolling.
No!
Verdict not guilty.